Hi guys, welcome to the second part of this tutorial to draw an elevation of a floor plan. So, after drawing the elevation of the walls, we will continue making the roof. And first, we are going to draw this one on the left. So, as you may understand, both roofs have the same size. And that means I can simply copy these objects here. Okay, but let's be sure that the distances are the same. I can do it by using the tool Measure, which is this icon located here, or I could also type DI. I'm going to this intersection, click here, and measure until the other side. You can see it's 8.2 meters. If I go to the roof at the right, press enter to activate the previous command, and then I have to click in distance. As you see, I could use a different measure utility. After measuring this line, we can confirm the distances are the same. So, let's go back to our drawing. I'm going to use the command copy, CO, press enter, select everything, and also these lines that were not selected. So I only select this line. Okay, I press enter. Then, to specify the base point, I'm going to click here. Of course, this vertical line, it was selected accidentally, but it's not a problem, I can delete it after. I place it here. Press escape, and then select this line and press delete. Now, I want to show you a characteristic when I draw overlapped lines. If I drag the mouse over this horizontal line, I can see these two squares one over the other. It means there are overlapped objects here. I'm going to click, and this window shows me I have two lines overlapped, and this allows me to choose the one I wish. By the way, this is a status bar tool called selection cycling, so I need to have this icon active. Now, let's switch it off to see the difference. I'm going to click again in the line. It is selected, but maybe it's not the object that I would like. So I prefer to use most of the time the selection cycling. Let's switch it on again, click again in the line, then I click in the second line, which is a bit shorter than the first one. It ends in this intersection. Okay, but if now I look to our drawing, there is this detail here, which is a bit different from the roof on the other side. Let's go to our drawing. First, we are going to create a line with the command line, press enter, go to the intersection, this endpoint. I go to this intersection, drag to the right. Okay, sometimes the line disappears. Do it again. And the dashed line disappeared again. Because happens that I have the object snap mode nearest turned on, it's represented by this icon, and what does is snapping the next point to the closest object, which in this case is the construction line in red. The problem is that acts as a priority and the other snap modes don't appear. So I click in the arrow next to the object snap and untick the mode nearest. This time is going to be easier. Aha, now I can find the intersection. Then draw another line until here. Then I can connect the remaining lines. So, it's done. And now to copy this to the other side, I can use the command mirror. I type MI and press enter. Select these lines, press enter again, and then find the midpoint of this line, click on it, and the objects will be copied symmetrically to the other side, as you see. Press enter and choose no to keep the original objects. Okay, so this roof is done. Then, let's continue with the main roof, and the first thing I'm going to do is to connect this intersection to this another in the other side. With the command line, I draw between both corners. Very simple, but it's important that you see this polar mode tracking. Next part. In this projection, I can see all these lines here. And I draw them using the corners of this detail. But first, I'm going to make them until the other end of the roof. I am going to draw lines until this construction line here. I activate the command line, go to this end point and draw a horizontal line until the intersection to this construction line. Then I can do the same for all the others or use the command offset. And as you may know how to do this, I fast forward this part. Once I finish, I have to increase this line. I click on it. If I have the selection cycling turned on, I select line and extend it until there. For the part below, I select the lines I just created and copy to this place. Activate command copy. Select these four lines, keeping the line below unselected. Press enter then. For the base point, I choose this one here, because this line is already there. I can simply move, as you see, and copy these lines to this endpoint. You can see how they look like. Now, I only have to get rid of the sections that are beyond this vertical line. I'm going to use the command trim, select only these lines, including the vertical one, press enter and click in these sections to erase them. Great. Now it remains the roof on the left of the building. This projection is almost the same as in the other parts, except this angle here, which is smaller. So I'm going to skip this part, as now you are able to draw this by yourself. Now let's draw this detail at the top. And you will need these measurements provided here. First, I'm going to draw a line at the distance of 4.1 Press enter. Draw it vertically until here. Press escape. Then another of 0.15, and I can use the command offset. Distance type 0.15. Then again, and this time I type 2.5. Click in the one I just created. And this time again 0.15 and click. Then I'm going to use the command trim to delete all this part. Select everything around here. Oh, this was not necessary, but it's okay. I have to erase in 2 times. I forgot these parts, but I can reactivate the command trim. Select all again and click in the lines to delete. Then I need this line of 0.57 meters. That means I need to increase this one to that distance. Click in this point. Then I have to press tab 3 times. And with this, the value I enter with the keyboard is the total distance. I type 0.57. Then I go to the other side and do the same with this line. I click here. Move the pointer towards the end of the last line. Drag to the right slowly to find here this intersection. By clicking now, I increase this line to 0.57 meters. Now, I will make this little detail here. It consists in lines and in one arc. And here you can see the dimensions. Returning to our plan, I start drawing a line from this endpoint until the left. Its length will be 0.4. The next one will be a vertical one, and when I see the polar tracking, I type 0.15. Then press escape. And now I'm going back to the model, and I realized I forgot to draw this line. And this means I have to draw it now, it's not a problem. You can see here that it's missing. Again, I type L, press enter, and draw a line until the construction line located in the side. Then, back to this part, I have to draw an arc there. I go to the icon arc, click in this arrow below, and I choose the option start center end. Before drawing, it's important to know that the arcs are drawn anti-clockwise. So, for the first point, I click in this end point. But of course, first you need to draw a line here of 0.1 meters. So, I click here for the first point. Then the center, I need to hover this endpoint. Scroll down until I find this intersection here. This is the center, and then the endpoint is this one. After this, the next step, I'm going to copy the objects I created symmetrically to the other part. For this, I'm going to use the command mirror. But first, I'm going to draw a line between these corners, as with its midpoint, I can place here the mirror line. To use mirror command, I type MI, select these three objects, press enter. Now, with the midpoint of this line, I draw a vertical mirror line, and you can see these new objects being placed there. Click, and then to keep the original objects, I click No here. To draw this front arc, I'm going to use this dimension here of 1.1. I go back to the exercise, and from the midpoint draw a line with that measurement. Press Escape. Again with the command arc, but this time instead, I'm going to choose the option 3-point. With this option, I can draw an arc using 3 points. First point, I click in this endpoint. This is my second one, and this will be the third one. For the second arc, I will extend this line in a distance of 0.15. For that, I could type directly 0.15, or to specify a new total length of the line, I press Tab 3 times to edit the total length here. I press 1.25, the total length. Press Enter. And here you have it. So, finally, again with the command arc, and it's recommendable to click always in the option that we want, in this case 3-point. I go to this endpoint, drag up to find this intersection, and click for the first point. This is the second point, and the third point. I'm going to do the same, hover this endpoint, and go slowly again until this intersection. Okay, the arc is finally done. Then, I just need to get rid of these extra lines here. And I am sure you know how to do it. So, it's everything in this part. Thank you very much for watching. And if you are not a subscriber yet to this channel, you know how to do if you have interest, of course. So, see you next time!